Tinted headlights. This could be a while. It's original. That VL, that fuel pump's outside the car, that's why you can't hear it on VLs. Or other modern cars. That coupe sounds good.
Directions.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Can't film all three at once.
kind of like it.
Try it first.
Yeah. What group in front? They go fair way.
Redman 2000.
Come in. Come across. Come across. Where's the next turn?
Put Adelaide.
So we're going to go right and stop here. Well, hopefully here we'll bunch up again, like get dudes bunching up around us.
Time for a Sunday, are we? Oh, fucking wank it. Sunday drivers. How's she running, Matt?
What?
How's she running?
Not too bad. As long as I don't plan it, like straight away, like loaded up a bit.
Just ease it up and then.
Once I've done about 3 grand, just let it root.
Beautiful. Better than it was the other day when I had a ride. Thank you. Jimmy.
Hey.
How you doing, man?
Here's a few. What's that turbo again? Okay, piece of shit in front of us. Dog in there.
Got a lot. How you doing?
Just got him going sideways.
Fully flipped that one. That thing's actually got, see that arm thing on the boot there? It's actually an ultraviolet light that shines into the boot. And the boot has got the stereo on. It's fucking heavy.
Oh, weird. One of those things.
Oh, yeah, it's really weird. Where was the next turn?
Park.
It's gonna be boring and ask for directions. That's Dave.
Miles in front.
Pretty much, can't see him. Do you want me to film from over here?
Cool, nice. Get a good look down there actually. Do the front. Where's Zoom on this fucking? Thank you.
rest of the crews is catching up. There's a lot of headlights behind us.
Excellent.
Excellent. Sideways around here, watch this deal.
Gemini rally.
This roundabout is breaking us up some fears.
Joined it.
They just fucking shot straight out in front of us. So.
Oh yes, this will be good. We have a contender.
No, just be fucking around.
It's actually wood, a wood paneled interior. That's all we're around the outside.
Fucking hell.
That's the funniest Toro I've ever seen.
Signs, everybody's not a Gemini, please move the left flank.
98 VTSS. Oh, that's pretty cool. This is where you need to take it. As you mentioned, take it. Let's go, people.
Beep. here.
Screen two, take it. Say go right down the road, didn't it?
Yeah.
I missed that vital bit of fun. What's the next turn we're doing? So we don't get lost again. Maybe there's no turn we're going. Oh, it's still full of water. Right. Trying to confirm. How's that new mate?
It's pretty good, eh? You're gonna get lost in the back screen, you might as well be in a convoy like six Jimmys.
Some point.
Well then I need to film then.
Classic.
I'm stopping for two.
Red?
Yeah.
He's down the road down there, like he's got an avalanche of coolant coming out from under his bonnet. I think he's out.
Oh, that was alright.
You should fucking score each owner and say, hey, dude, what's in your car? And I can tell you briefly.
What is it?
Matt, tell the man what's in it.
Oh, that's just a 16, forward to 18, TO3, Garrett. Just, you know, worked here, I don't know.
Just one.
Yeah.
One valve.
Thank you.
it's amazing, not that much money spent on it, it's just that pitch and after it. The rest of the car has basically been like for quite some time.
You have a good spin on it, bring it up to the
Oh yeah, that's right. All the page and window deck and stuff, yeah.
There's only one, it's just a token appearance. Thank you.
So you're going to need to do is tell us where to park, because
I've got directing, so that's fine.
That dude's black van should be down the front.
Yeah, it should.
My mind's suffering from getting exhausted. Get out more ground stuff on there.
That's a good idea.
Car club to run on the drag racing car that we have, the orange Gemini panel van, which is currently down in the Coonawarra doing some drag racing down there, and then it goes to Wowla next month and Mildura the month after. So basically we are a car club. We run the night, we just ran the basically the 9th annual South Australian Fours and Rotary Show. There's a handful of us in the car club. We spend about 5 to 6 months planning it, getting all the interstaters across here, organising all the trophies, t-shirts, venues, raceway, all that sort of stuff. It does take quite a bit of time, and it's very rewarding on the day when you look around and see 100 cars entered for the racing, and you see guys like Rotormaster and Rocco's Performance, and the guys from Promaz and Crystal. I don't know if you guys saw it on the left there, there's a large 100 out there, the blue one. So he came across from Geelong, so we actually run that show. Just finished it, obviously. I don't know how many of you guys actually made it to it, but it was the best we've actually run. The car club's car now gets another engine, a new roller bearing servo, intercooler, etc. to hopefully run consistent 10s. It snapped into a 10 with a 1092 when everything was perfect, so hopefully we can run consistent 1080s in the thing. Basically, that's it. We do plenty of crews. One, shoot the shit out of each other with paintballs, and that's a bloody good event, actually. We do plenty of crews. It's basically what members want to do. Members want to do this, we all put hands up and say, yeah, we want to do that. We don't actually plan the events until we get ideas from you guys. Simple things like cruises, observation runs. We then have Tembian bowling nights where you go to that moonlight stuff where all the lights are off and you try to get the shit out of the coloured pink. Anything the members actually want to do. So we're a very member-oriented club. We do go across to the Fours and Rotary Nationals. I just came back from there a few weeks ago over in Goulburn. Once again, we have been there, I suppose, 5 times in the last 8 years. Not as entrance at a couple of them, then it gets too far to drive your car. So we still drove across anyway, but to show the car's a bit of a pain in the bum. But we are well known to the editors of Hot Fours and Fast Fours magazines and all the rest, and one of SA's leading car clubs financially. So a well worth car club to join, and as you can see, there's bugger all members' cars out here, and a lot of public cars, which is fantastic to see. So, yeah, thanks very much for coming along. Everyone can just stand around, have a bit of a chat, ask questions, whatever. And we will run another event. This was the 25th anniversary, March 1975, that the TX Gemini was released. We were cruised 4 years ago for the 21st, and no doubt we'll do a cruise in 5 years' time for the 30th. We'll see how many Geminis are left on the road in 5 years' time. It's a lot of effort, obviously, some of these cars. So I think most of these cars will still be around in 5 years. So once again, thank you all for coming along. I do have some applications for membership to our car club. $25 a year for single, $35 for joint. And once again, meeting on the first Monday every month. And for your membership, basically the car club puts together a Christmas dinner, which the club pays for financial members. And that can cost anywhere from $40 to $50 a head, so once you've paid your $25, you're guaranteed to get it back at Christmas time. We went for a Port River cruise last Christmas. We actually hired one of those, or booked it out. Went for a Port River cruise. It takes about 4 hours, at 7 o'clock until about 11. And food and stuff on that, and the club pays for it, so it's definitely well worth being a member. And yes, it's one of Adelaide's longest surviving clubs. 12 years the club's been around. I've been in it for 9. We've got some other members who have been in there slightly longer than that. So yeah, that's basically about it. So yes, the first Monday of every month at the Business Hotel. And I can't even answer, say. We also do regular drag racing meets as well. I work out there. We've got plenty of guys who actually come out there for the street meets. A couple of those cars are down in the southeast at the moment, racing the 8th mile tri-series. But we do have a few turbo cars in the club already who are doing 12 seconds, 12s and 13s, and they're only brand new, basically, on the road. Dennis from Jimmy Spares helps us keep all the cars on the road, where they're building this, building that. Turbo injecting quite a few cars. I suppose there's about a dozen cars out there running microsec injection for Haltech, and now I suppose there's about 7 or 8 turbo cars which he regularly works on. So yes, if anyone needs any work done, I would definitely go to Dennis for a quote. Whether or not you go there to get it done is another thing, but you do find the after service, especially to members of the car club. Once you remember, the price is basically labour on top of what he charges for the parts is next to nothing. So which is what basically keeps us going there all the time. So once again, thanks. everyone for coming along. Stand around, have a chat. We'll take a few photos, send them into Holden next week. And get him into the Advertiser for Stuart Innes, who's been a long time motoring editor for the Advertiser. He actually test drove the TX Gemini back in 75 out on Adelaide International Raceway. He did a story on us a little while ago, which basically promoted this event. And thank God we've got quite a few cars out of it, which is fantastic. So thanks for coming, everyone. Remember your forms to the club if you wish. Any other questions, you can fire away.
What's the tunnel? It
wasn't me.
You're right.
Yeah. No, there's nothing to support me.
Hi, Gemini!
These are all the rubber blocks and the bumpers and stuff like that, you know? It's a bit busy at the front. We're going to put the TG front on. That front looks smoother. I think it's the one on the van, on the green one.
Dude's got the right idea. Mullins and Packers Union, all right. All right, I fucking will, man.
Thank you. about it.
Get me out the corner, Ross.
East end ramp coming back or something.
Yeah, that's right.